Hey everyone, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner, and I am back with another reaction video. If you have listened to this channel for a while, or if you have not, I am a big gospel fan, and as I stated a few times, I actually sang gospel for 4 years. This group is one of the greatest vocal groups ever in the history of gospel music. And they changed the game for a lot of people who came after them. I'm talking about the Mighty Clouds of Joy. It came out in the 60s. And they were together in various iterations for over 60 years. The original members, unfortunately, are now deceased. May they rest in eternal peace. But what they gave us on those albums, wow, wow, wow. Great stuff. They were formed in 1959 in LA. And they were a traditional group. You know, the quartet, the gospel quartet, with the guitar accompaniment. That's how it was then. But if you remember when I talked about James Cleveland, who came out in the 50s, in the 60s, he started incorporating soul, R&B. Mighty Clouds of Joy were kind of on a parallel track to James Cleveland. He was on the East Coast, they were on the West Coast. What they did was they added bass, drums, and keyboards to that guitar backup. They started incorporating R&B and soul and rock into their music, into the gospel music that they did. One of their early hits was produced by legendary icons Gamble and Huff. They were funky, straight up funky. The other thing about them was, unlike other groups of the period, and you see this album cover here, they dress nice, very stylishly. At one point, they had the same tailor as the Temptations. And you know the Temptations used to look fierce. The Lord never said that you couldn't look fly when you praise him. Just saying. They had the nice suits, you know what I'm saying? You know, all, you know, stylish. They had style. And they also had some really slick choreography, which people hadn't seen with quartets. You know, they had the moves too. Very popular. Had a very strong fan base for many years. And they were just a great group. Great, great group. And they had a big crossover LP in 1974. It's called It's Time. It's a really good album. And what people loved about them was that even though the music was, you know, secular, the message of the music, the religious message of the music was never diluted with them. They praised the Lord big time every time. It didn't matter what the music was. And this is the best, I think, example of that. This record was a number one club classic. and it's got a very strong religious message to it. We didn't care. We thought it was funky, and we bought it. This is the Mighty Clouds of Joy, with probably their best known record ever, and a club dance classic. It went to number one on the dance chart. This is called Mighty High, and it's from 1975.
You
Mighty Clouds of Joy from 1975. Mighty High. That's one of them songs. Listen to it in the disco on Saturday and sing it in church on Sunday. They got tremendous flack for this, as you can well imagine, by black churchgoers who said it was too secular. Two other records that came out in the 80s, also gospel, but club classics, 1983, the Clark Sisters. Twinkie wrote that joint, "You Brought the Sunshine." Ooh, they got crucified for that one. That's a banger. And then my all-time favorite of this type of song, Tremaine Hawkins, "Fall Down," "Spirit of Love." Absolute club classic. They don't make them like that anymore, for sure. Props to the Mighty Clouds of Joy for giving us a club classic and keeping it real. As always, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner. Please like, click, share, subscribe for more content. I will be back with some more from the iPod. Take care.